Welcome to May. This is your general reading that will cover the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the best part of the month, the biggest challenge, and then guidance and give you your crystal of the month that'll help you get through it as unscathed and as easy as possible, okay? It'll help you with all the things that you need. So, this is for your sun sign. Career videos are gonna look like this and they'll come out soon. So make sure you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell so you know when they come out. They are for your rising sign. This video right here will tell you why that is if you're not sure. And then love videos come out halfway through the month and this is what they're gonna look like, okay? So let's get started. If you're interested in what decks I'm using for this reading, I've got the Cosmic Tribe Tarot. Looks like this. And then the Angel Prayers Oracle by Kyle Gray. If you purchase them through the affiliate links down below, I might get a couple cents, which would be helpful in me continuing to make these videos because YouTube pays you like, I don't know, $20 a year. but it doesn't cost you anything extra. So I would appreciate that if you're interested in buying a deck. And so, Cancer, the general theme for you this month is confusion. What do I prioritize? There's so many things going on. What's the most important thing for me? But what they're saying is it doesn't matter. Just start one, right? Maybe there's a lot of things on your to-do list and you don't know what comes first, the chicken or the egg. What do I do? Well, throw them all in a bowl and pull one out and just start on that. Just start on something. Because once you get the momentum going, then things kind of move for you in the direction that you want them to. I would say for the majority of you, whatever is the most, the least mentally taxing, but the most physically laborious is where I would start if I were a Cancer sun sign. Just because our physiology kind of determines our psychology sometimes, and the more we move our body, the more we move our energies, the less stagnant things are, and the more clear-headed and clear thinking we have, which makes those more mental tasks easier. So that's the general theme for the month of May for you. So what does the beginning, middle, and end of the month look like? So the beginning, it's like, oh my gosh, when am I going to come out of this cocoon? Like, when are things going to change? When am I going to break free and spread my wings and things are going to be beautiful? Well, there's all that confusion energy surrounding you right now, right? And so I think that's part of that whole process of just picking the physical thing that you can do first. Also, like, if one of the things on your list is clean your house, well, a decluttered space is a decluttered mind, okay? So there's that. In the middle of the month, the energy is almost this fear, like I'm not going to be successful or people are not going to appreciate what I'm doing or, you know, even notice what I'm doing here. You know, maybe that you're not seen, which doesn't usually end up to be a problem for Cancers because sometimes you don't want to be. You know, you're the hermit card. You want to go in your little shell sometimes. But you need a little bit of that in the middle of the month. And it's a challenge for you that other people aren't seeing you necessarily that way. So what do you do about it? They're like, well, there's not much you can do about it. So most of you are going to be inclined to sort of try to avoid thinking about it, to close your eyes to it, to say it doesn't matter. But what you need to do again is add that physical action. You know, maybe you want to reach out to friends. Maybe you want to toot your own horn a little bit. Make a social media post about all of your successes. Like, look at how much I've gotten done around the house or something like that. I know it sounds silly and it's not necessarily your characteristic and trait, but it's going to be something that actually benefits you, okay? It's going to help you to feel less stuck and less icky here. Now, at the end of the month, you're like, oh man, I'm not really satisfied. I'm not getting what I want. So, I mean, kind of sounds like a downer month for you, right? But the whole message here, the general theme, is that you can control this per the physical actions that you're taking. They're like, you know, you're not really feeling yourself. You're not really like feeling your most beautiful, like your most clever, your most charming and smart. And they're saying like this energy doesn't change if your routines don't change. And so I feel like at least for the month of May, it's really important that Cancers specifically have something in the beginning of the day where they're moving their body around and thus moving their energy around, because then it won't be such a hard month for you. But for those of you who maybe like wake up and you go and you sit down and you work on your computer straight out the gate, it's going to be a struggle. It's going to be kind of a just like a month of the blahs, which sometimes is worse than straight up depression, because then you're all paranoid and panicked about why you feel nothing, and are you even capable of feeling? Because if you're not capable of feeling, can you even feel joy? Should it come down the pipe, right? And so that's the whole thing here. It's really, really important to move your body and make a routine of it in the beginning of the day for Cancers, at least in the month of May. So, best part of the month for you is if you're able to create that routine. Holy shit, does it do you a lot of favors? Does it make your world more colorful and beautiful? Biggest challenge of the month is, like, you don't have a lot of choices and options, you feel like, and you feel like things are maybe unstable. So that could totally be true, you know, with the coronavirus stuff, depending on where you live and what your job is and all of that stuff. I mean, that's a legitimate feeling. So what they say is, notice where you feel the feeling in your body. Put your hand over that. Like, do I feel nervous in my stomach? So I'm going to put my hand right here, okay? And just go, oh, I noticed that. But don't judge it. Don't do anything else. Just notice it and then let it go. And then I would maybe, you know, stand up and move my energy around. Even if it's just for a few seconds. Like, you don't have to pick up some massive workout routine, right? But it's just like, do something. I think that's the thing, is like, we're getting too stuck in our head and we're feeling stagnant, which just bogs down our energy and makes you feel kind of shitty. So it's just like, pull one thing out of a bowl and go. So your crystal of the month is sodalite. And so there's many reasons why that will help you with this reading. I don't want to go into it and make the video much longer, but the article that I have for the description, meaning, uses, all of its benefits, is right here. You can find it on my blog page. I love you so much, and I'll see you next month.